strife of truth design. Ere cause bring fame and profit.
You don't have to sing it that loud.
Nah, mate, no, I do.
No, because it's a nice song.
Yeah, but when I sing, it encourages everyone else to join in and sing too.
Sure, but you don't sing very well. I think it'd be better if you just perhaps mimed a little or really quietly so no one can hear you.
No, Nick, you're missing the whole point. The whole point is that I do sing.
Right.
It's
even though
worship.
You can't sing?
It's called worship. And we need to get into that. We need to just sing with everything we've got. I mean, you ought to try this. This is great. And this is a great hymn to get into. And so, Nick, singing is actually really great for us.
Mm.
And that's 606, once to every man and nation, there's a moment to decide. And today we're actually making some decisions too. We're in week 6 of this UR Church journey.
Yeah, Manuel 2. Thank you for joining us.
Yeah.
And what a fantastic week it's going to be for you in your small groups. Last time you guys met, it would have been about the attitude of worship. This time, it's about the key elements of worship in this paradigm shift. And we're going to look at 3 different key elements. First one being giving. Now the Bible says, Neil, it is better to
give than receive.
Receive.
Now here it's about the attitude you have, about being generous, being willing to give something away. Now here, obviously finances would be one of the first things we think of, our tithes and offerings.
Mm-hmm.
And yet it's so much more than tithes and offering. It's our time, it's our energy, it's our focus. Actually, it's our heart.
Yeah. So instead of going
really
to church,
when we come to church, we really want to come and we want to give ourselves as an offering to God.
Right.
Not just the things we have, but ourselves.
So instead of thinking of the things that you can take away, what's church going to do for me today and what am I going to get out of it, it's more of what you're going to be putting into it.
That's it.
Yeah, fantastic. The other key element is the voice.
Yeah.
Now you gave us a really good demonstration of what sound like.
You know, you might need earplugs and whatever, and if my daughter's listening to that, she's going to shoot me. But aside from that, actually just being willing to give God your voice as well, yeah. Because when we sing, it actually just changes our whole physiology.
Sure.
When you open up and you sing and you just want to praise, you want to worship God, actually in those moments, and I've had lots of those moments, not all the time, but lots of those moments where I just feel a closeness with God through singing
that
I don't ordinarily experience.
And we're not talking about the worship team up front, we're talking about everybody.
It's about
joining in.
So you think, I now give God my heart, I'm opening up to Him, and now I'm going to sing with my voice.
Even if I don't have a good voice, Neil.
Even if I don't have a good voice. Yeah. Hey, you know, lots of places the organ's loud enough that it's not going to matter anyway.
Sure.
Or if it's not the organ, it's the praise and worship band or the piano or whatever it is. But the minute you focus on you, you've made it about you.
Sure.
And it's not about you, it's about you giving worship to God.
Nice. That's really cool.
Yeah.
And the final element here is active listening.
Yeah, that's kind of a curious
one. Active listening.
One, isn't it?
The church is designed, if you look at the church for example, for you just to simply sit down and listen and not do much more than that.
What's active
listening about?
So active listening, you know, there's a lot of people who will get out one of these during church, you know, and they'll be Facebooking and they'll be doing all sorts of things. They'll be doing anything but listening.
Sure.
So active listening is actually tuning in and saying, okay, what's the blessing in what I'm hearing today?
Okay.
What's the take-home message for me? What is it that God's really wanting me to hear today?
So it's anticipating what God has this message.
It's actually expecting that God's going to bless you with something today.
Nice. Awesome. So there's a challenge in this week, and I think you guys need to take this on. How many times have we, as church members, contacted our pastors or anyone who's organized to be preaching on that Sabbath and prayed for them? Or ask them the question, hey, is there anything I can do for you in preparing you for the Sabbath?
Imagine what it'd be like if everyone in our church was in regular contact with the pastor and says, hey, or whoever's preaching, hey, I've got a great message for you this week. I just want to pray for you for your message this week. I'm going to pray that God's going to do something really special at church.
Yeah.
And then you just come with that expectation that the Holy Spirit's going to turn up.
That would be wonderful.
And the church is going to be a place of blessing, that people's hearts are going to be touched, lives transformed.
Oh, man, imagine the whole church doing that.
Yeah, it'd be pretty cool.
That would be fantastic. Yeah. So there's the challenge. Give it a shot. It's going to be an awesome week. Enjoy the discussions, and we'll catch you next time on UR Church.
Yeah, we'll see you then. Bye.